Okay. For the city of Thebes, and for this rash man who is now its king. Pentheus, Pentheus, beware Cadmus, the echo of that name. Pentheus, beware, Pentheus, the echo of that name. Thank you. stop and reflect. Rest. There is nothing but eternity. Infinity. La 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 la
are pretty. Your curls are beautiful. I take it that you don't care much for athletics. Your complexion is ravishing, but you mustn't let the harsh sun strike it. No, preserve it for the special joys of night. Where are you from?
Lydia.
Lydia, and why did you come to Thebes?
Dionysus, the son of Zeus, sent me.
In Lydia, you have a Zeus who begets new gods?
He is no different than yours. I saw him.
You dreamt that you saw him.
I saw him. He made me the keeper of his sacred rites.
What are they like, these rites?
They are secret, except to those who are allowed to know them.
What good is it, then, in knowing them?
I may not tell you, but they are worth knowing.
You calculate your words to make me the more curious.
No, I do not. Our rites abhor the unbeliever.
You said that you saw Zeus. How did he look?
As he chose to look.
Another evasion.
Wisdom is always folly to fools.
These rites, are they performed by day or by night?
Night, mostly. Darkness befits solemnity.
And befits fornication even better.
It happens in the daytime.
You will be punished the more for your agile answers.
And you the more for your irreverence.
In wrestling with words, you are quite athletic.
Tell me, this interest in fornication, is it based wholly on moral grounds?
You shall regret that.
And how do you propose to make me regret it?
You shall be imprisoned.
And the god will free me when I ask, for he is with us now, witnessing the abuse that I endure.
I see no god. He mocks me. Bind him.
I warn you, do not.
And I say, bind him.
You do not know what you do. You do not know your desires. How would you like, for example, to be seen here disguised as a woman?
What?
Do you even know who you are?
I am Pentheus, son of Achaeon and Agave.
Pentheus. Unlucky Pentheus. Unlucky in that name. Pentheus.
Take him. And since he prefers darkness, jail him in the darkest stable. There, let him dance.
Oh, 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 oh.
And Zeus has snatched him from the lightning.
Closer, dear, closer, dear. Oh, the wolf and his mother is high. Thank you.
yours is the power.
And yours the glory.
Instead of me, he found a bull. A bull. Ha! A man who dares to confront a god. Here he is now. Let him storm.
Well, how did you escape me? Answer!
Walk softly here. Your anger is out of place.
How did you escape?
Didn't you hear me before? I said that someone would free me whenever I asked.
Clever, but not clever enough.
More than enough when I need to be. Here, a herdsman from Kithaeron. And I think he has a story to tell you. First I saw three bands of bacchanals. Your own mother Agave was among them. They were sleeping the sleep of exhaustion wherever they happened to fall. Then your mother heard the lowing of our cattle, rose up and cried, "Shake the sleep away!" Suddenly the place was filled with women, matrons, maidens, young girls. Some cradled fawns or wolf cubs in their arms. Others, young mothers who had left their babes at home, suckled wild things at their swollen breasts. They fastened their skins about them with writhing snakes. Exhausted finally, they retired to their fountains where they washed while serpents licked the blood from their cheeks. Oh, my king, welcome this god to the city. He is great in other ways also, for I am told he is the divinity of wine. When wine is no more, love is no more, and that will be the end of joy in the world.
The fire spreads, and we must act at once, or we shall become the shame of Greece. Go, give the order to the swiftest of the horsemen. Rouse the archers. It passes all bounds to endure from women what we now endure.
You will not hear me, Pentheus. You will do exactly what you wish, yet I must tell you, beware. Do not war against a god. It were more appropriate to offer him a sacrifice.
He will get his sacrifice. And the woods of Kithaeron are full of the victims. I only wish I could catch them in their foul acts.
My friend, let us discuss the situation.
Enough of this! Where is my armor?
Wait. You say you would like to catch them. How would you like to see these rebels?
See them? Yes, I would like to see them.
I'm afraid I'll have to suggest that you wear women's clothes.
Me? In a dress? Ridiculous. What must I wear?
First, a wig with long and beautiful curls. A net for your hair and a dress falling to your feet.
I can't do it. No, no! I can't bear to be ridiculed. Let me think about it. in a woman's dress. A net for my hair.
Our fish is ensnared. The revelers he shall see for a prize. Madden this man, possess his soul. His threats so foul, pay him back. Show him on the streets of Thebes a woman. Now I must go to assist with his toilet. Crooked.
Only on the right, I think. The left hem seems straight. Should I hold the wand like this or like this?
No, with the right hand, and time the stroke with your right foot. That's better. I commend your spirit of cooperation.
I shall hide among the pine trees.
You shall find a nest for spying, the one that you have earned.
Imagine, already I can see them there, mating furiously, caught in the throes of love.
That is your purpose, to watch. You may catch them by surprise, or they may catch you.
I, alone among the people of Thebes, dare to do this?
You and you alone are doing this for Thebes. I will lead you there, but someone else will bring you back.
My mother?
She will carry you in her arms for all to see.
Such luxury, nestled in my mother's arms.
Gloriously, this is your destiny.
You are too good to me.
You are an unusual young man, and you go to a strange and unusual experience.
It is my reward.
Yes, a fame ascending to the skies. Gargamel, I bring you your son. Reach out your arms.
My mother. so softly.
An extraordinary kill, indeed. Extraordinary.
actually.
Ah, Pentheus, he must come. And my father, where is he? Where are they? The men of Thebes use nets and spears and boast of their prowess. But here is a quarry brought down by the bare hands of women. And a young lion.
No more, no more, no more, no more.
Father!
If you are so fortunate as to abide in your present mind till the day you die, you will seem to be happy, even though cursed.
Father, what are you saying?
Daughter, look up to heaven.
Yes, I am looking.
Does it seem the same? Or does it seem different now?
The sun is beginning to come up. It seems more bright, more clear than before.
And is the sickness still tossing about in your head?
Sickness? Yes, I feel strange.
Yet you can hear and answer me.
No, Father. Yes, I hear, but I forget.
Whose head? Whose do you hold in your arms? Look at it.